while another drops a similar distance from the belly of the aircraft and transmits AM frequencies. Several planes make up the PSYOPS unit called Commando Solo. They can be refueled in the air, giving them virtually unlimited range. As part of Operation Desert Storm, PSYOPS broadcasts help persuade Iraqi troops to surrender. But Operation Uphold Democracy in Haiti in October 1994 is its biggest success so far. The US military's mission was to back ousted President Jean-Bertrand Aristide in overthrowing the de facto military regime. Commando Solo broadcast messages in Creole. Appeals for calm were interspersed with news panel discussions and local music. Other broadcasts were aimed at stemming refugee flotillas. Messages informed them that they would not be allowed to enter the United States.
We were able to turn off the refugees, prepare the country, and to provide an alternative to invasion so that when Aristide did return, it was a peaceful return of a legitimate power. And that is the ultimate goal of psychological operations. We were able to basically win a contingency, I wouldn't call it a war, without firing a shot.
But this system does have its limitations. Anyone can turn off the propaganda by turning off their radio or television. The ultimate weapon in the info war would be so secret, so invisible, so undetectable, you would never know your mind was under attack. At Laurentian University in Ontario, Canada, a young student is about to undergo one of the strangest experiences of her life. They're hooking Denise's brain up to an electroencephalograph, or EEG machine. For 30 to 40 minutes, this will monitor her brain waves. While these electric coils attached on either side of her head will immerse her brain in an electromagnetic field. Her brain actually completes the circuit between the two coils. The field pulsing through her brain is less powerful than one given off by a digital clock radio. But acutely controlled and focused at specific parts of the brain, it will open Denise's mind to outside suggestion by this man.
I'm going to do a switch to see its right left hemisphere. Use your frontal temporal.
Dr. Michael Persinger is a professor of psychology and neuroscience. He is designing ways to put the power of mind control to good use. Dr. Persinger's research focuses on brain trauma. And he uses carefully controlled doses of electromagnetic radiation to induce relaxation and alleviate pain.
So what Sandra did was to initiate a opiate releasing pattern. That's a burst firing field that is stimulated once every 4 seconds. And that produces relaxation and a very pleasant sensation. Similarly, using the appropriate field, we can induce fear and apprehension, but clearly that would be unethical in that setting.
Dr. Persinger's tests suggest that carefully programmed electromagnetic frequencies can tap into individual brains and influence people's emotions.
The cognitive processes of the human brain are really quite simple. And if you understand how they work, you can make entire populations think and decide the manner in which you wish.
Many experts are skeptical of such an Orwellian scenario, but Persinger thinks the implications are chillingly real.
Suppose you generate a field that produces fear, fundamental fear, in large numbers of people. And then, over the television, more traditional ways, you say, the reason we're having this fear is because of this particular group. And now you start to move the population believing in a direction that you wish.
To influence 250 million people, the equivalent of the entire population of the United States, may not be that difficult. According to Dr. Persinger, we already have the technology, satellites and television, and radio transmitters. Mind control may already be happening. We know the mysterious PSYOPS plane can beam persuasive sounds and pictures into people's television sets. Will it someday beam disturbing frequencies directly into the mind? Mind control will be the ultimate non-lethal weapon. The prospect of a war without pain or death where victory comes without a single shot being fired, should be a cause for jubilation. Smart military technologies and non-lethal weapons could at least prevent the awful carnage of large-scale head-to-head combat. What then can we expect of war in the 21st century? Which will frighten us more, the threat of unspeakable destruction from plasma cannons and lasers on high, or the prospect of national computer crashes? Paradoxically, the promise of truly bloodless war may come only with the most devastating weapon of all. If the human mind and will become the battleground of the future, War 2020 may be won without so much as a whimper, let alone a bang.